Yeah. But I told her, why would you wanna? I said to her, yeah. But I told her, why would you wanna? I said to her one day, do you want another man? She, how many men does she want to marry? 3, 4, 5? What's enough? I said, stay focused on the marriage together, yeah? But I said, your children are going to look at you like not a good woman, you know? One marriage, okay. 2 marriages. What's wrong, you know? These women, they just jump ship at the straight away. There's a little problem, they're gone, you know? They don't want to. She never even tried to work things out. And I organized a marriage counselor. We had one session, okay? So we went to the marriage counselor that I organized, and the marriage counselor said, what do you want to achieve by coming here, Troy? And I said, I want better communication. And she asked my wife, what do you want by coming here? My wife said, so we can separate. And I said,
Let me ask you this. Yeah. Why would you go to a female marriage counselor? That's feminism right there. I can almost guarantee. Do you realize that according to DSM-4, prior to DSM-4, borderline personality disorder, which it sounds like she may have, and by the way, I'm not a psychiatrist or a psychologist, but I dealt with a few borderlines. Yep. Prior to DSM-5, borderline personality was diagnosed as primary a female disorder. With DSM-5, a lot of women came into the psychiatry and psychology profession, and they said, well, this is bias. We shouldn't say that. But it was primarily a female disorder, right? So now, women came into the profession, they're saying, well, this is bias. We can't use these type of terms, right? And so now you got feminism even into the psychiatry and psychology profession.
You're right. You know what? I had to get a female one, a counselor, and she was Vietnamese, so she could speak to my wife in Vietnamese, meaning English. You know what she said to me? I said to her that I said, I think my wife married me just to come into the country and get a visa. And the counselor says to me, you can't say that. That's very rude and very mean. And I said to her, but if it's the truth, I'm going to say it. She was already, you're right, she useless, right? She was sticking up for my wife. And that another time, I would answer the questions, but my wife, she wouldn't answer the questions, like, you know. And, yeah, it was not a productive experience. And I only did it because I was not desperate, but I was trying to do what I can, yeah? So we try, you know, but a waste of time.
Counseling from Eves. This is what I learned. A man doesn't take counseling from a woman if a man's a leader. The man doesn't take counseling. Generally, within we know what's right. We know the right thing to do as men. Sometimes we go against that inner voice, and that's when we start to make mistakes, right? But generally, we know what's best. You was trying to salvage that relationship. She really didn't want it because she was there for a purse, right? She was there for a financial gain, as many modernized women are. And accountability is something that the modern woman is just not willing to accept.
None. She went to the marriage counseling so she can tell her friends and family, like, oh, I went, you know, and I tried, you know. Her goal going there was to separate. I said, well, let's finish this here now, okay? We're done. And she said, oh, that's not the marriage counselor. Oh, that's not nice. I said, if she wants to separate, and why do we continue, yeah? So it was a disaster. Anyway, it's the thing you're supposed to do, isn't it, you know? That's life, you know. But Brother Kahan, you know, you're doing a good job. I appreciate all your, you know, content and stuff, because it's very informative and valuable to the right type of people, you know. But a lot of people out there are lost, yeah. We just got to remember, okay, there's only going to be a small number of us. It may grow, it may not, you know. But don't be discouraged by, you know, it's better quality, not quantity. Yeah. We want quality, not quantity.
Right.
Like, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
It works in the court.
Yeah. 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 I would just stay strong, brother. And I would just, you know, a wise man in Miami told me, man, the windshield is bigger than the rearview mirror. So I keep looking in the windshield, man, instead of that little small rearview mirror. Forget about what's behind you, man. Just keep moving forward, man, and progression. And that's what I learned. The more productive a man makes himself, the more a man works on himself, the more desire he is. He gets, the more choices he gives himself. You see? Your primary focus is always your purpose. You know, whatever you was put here to do, as long as you stay focused on that, you're going to always be attracted to other women. And women can lie and deny it, but attraction is not a choice. It's not a choice that they make. Because if a woman's attracted to a man, as long as she's within his vicinity, she could pretend she isn't, but deep down inside she is. She'll lie, but that attraction is still there. And I'm going to tell you something. Initially, when that woman first met you, there was something about you that attracted her to you, right? And so whatever that was, somewhere throughout the relationship, you may have start, because men sometimes would become complacent, right? We start acting too comfortable, right? We stop acting like with the dominant leadership and you know, we become like, we allow certain things that we initially wouldn't allow, right? Because women are always giving us these little shit tests, right? And then she's evaluating us throughout the entire relationship. So we got to remember to always remain how we was at the inception of the relationship. Right? We got to stay that way, man. And that's what's going to attract other women to us. See, women, you know what? Women can hear this video right now. They talk shit about me. But most of those women in the background, they'd be ready to get me to smash them. And this is what I know for a fact. So attraction is not a choice. It's not a choice that she makes. It's the way that men conduct themselves, the way that he progresses in life, that makes her attracted to him. And it's not, the only way she could not be attracted to him is to move herself from the situation. That's it. Because it's not a choice that, well, I'm going to be attracted to this man. See, people don't know when they actually fall in love, right? If you ask someone, well, at what point did you fall in love? You don't know. You just sort of thinking of the person more, right? There's no designated time that you initially fall in love with someone, because attraction is not a choice. It just happens.
I became distracted. I failed in the terms of I became distracted with my family. And because COVID came and then my family, I became distracted and I took my eyes off my business and my purpose, because my family was my important to me, And what happened, it was a curse, because she kept her eyes, she wanted money. So once I got her comfortable and I got her a license, the car, everything, she took off. And I didn't realize I had taken my eyes off my purpose. And, you know, I thought that making the family happy and you know, setting them up, they left me for dead. And I didn't realize at the time, And because of the COVID started a lot of it was like a domino effect when the COVID came, and then it started a lot of things, you know, all different for many people. Majority negative, unfortunately, but okay.
You know, the best thing you could do right now, I don't know if you work out, go and work out.
Yeah.
Get
I don't,
as
no,
fit as you can. You don't typically work out?
No, I've become very, like you said, see, I don't speak to many people, and I used to be very, very.
That's the worst thing you could do. You need to start hanging in social circles.
Yeah.
Start going on dates, date a few women just for, because that's going to, that's going to relift your self-esteem. You might be thinking something's wrong with you. There's nothing wrong with you. It's her.
Yeah.
It's her, right? She wants you, and I believe that this woman's probably a borderline. And they have a way. You see how you said in the beginning, she made you